Dear friends, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Neeraj Agarwal from University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management, Punjab University, Chandigarh. Now, I will be taking a module on basic sponges and cakes under the paper titled Food Production Operations and Management. After the completion of this modules, the learners can understand about basic sponges, their functions of each ingredient in cake making, able to understand the cake falls, able to know cake making methods, understand characteristics of the cakes, balancing of cake formula. The ingredients used in cake making are mostly flour, sugar, shortening or butter, egg, salt, liquid and leavening. The ingredients may vary in kind, quantity and method used. It is important to understand and recognize the function of ingredients in various cakes. Formula balance is the key to producing a good cake of any type. Firstly, we are going to discuss about the various ingredients used in cake making and their functions. The first one is flour. It should be bleached soft wheat flour. This produces a fine cell structure, fine grain and smooth texture. It gives structure to the cake and helps in the absorption of moisture. Thus, it is also an anti-staling agent. Sugar, it gives softness and color to the product. It helps in mechanical aeration, that is, while creaming the fat and sugar, friction takes place, which accounts for air incorporation. It is also an anti-staling agent because it is hydroscopic. It absorbs water. It also called a tenderizer as it makes cake softer. Shortening and fats. Those mainly used in cake making are butter, margarine, lard, etc. Shortening means cutting down of gluten strands. It helps in creaming for aeration and emulsification. That is, action between moisture and fat. It also gives color to the product and act as a lubricant. That is, it does not allow gluten strands to stick together. Eggs, it contributes to structure by working with the gluten in the flour. Egg binds and helps stabilize the batter. Whipped eggs holds air and allows it to expand during baking, supplying some leavening action. Moisture, color, flavor and eating qualities all contribute to the egg present in the cake making. The other optional ingredients are baking powder, a chemical leavening agent that in the presence of heat and moisture gives out carbon dioxide, which brings about aeration. Milk can be used in the form of fresh, condensed or powder. It helps in adjusting the consistency of the batter. It gives color to the crust because of the lactose present and gives richness to the product because of its fat content. Water, it helps in giving moisture to the batter and to adjust the consistency. Fruits and nuts, they enrich the batter and contribute to a variety of flavor and texture of the cake. Now, I'm going to discuss the different type of cakes and sponges. The methods uses fat, less sponge, beat eggs and sugar over hot water, add essence and fold, sieve flour with baking powder, add water and mild well. Put the mixture in a Swiss roll tray and bake at 400 degree Fahrenheit. In case of Swiss rolls, remove and turn out in a sugared paper, leaving the paper outside cool and use. Genoa sponge. Beat eggs and sugar over hot water. Add essence and fold in a sieved flour. Fold in the melted butter. Put the mixture in a prepared tin and bake at 400 degree Fahrenheit. Allow to cool and use as required. Butter sponge, sieve flour and baking powder, cream butter and sugar, beat eggs and essence and add gradually into the butter cream. Add milk and mix well. Put the mixture in a cake tin and bake at 375 degree Fahrenheit. Cool, cut and use. Chocolate sponge, sieve flour, baking powder and cocoa twice. Cream, butter, sugar well, beat eggs, add essence and mix gradually into the butter cream. Fold in flour, add milk and mix well. Put the mixture in a cake tin and bake at 375 degree Fahrenheit. Cool and use as desired. Madeira cake, sieve flour, baking powder, cream butter and sugar. Beat eggs and essence and mix gradually with butter cream. Fold flour, lemon rind, juice and bake. When it is half baked, seal the cracks with orange peel slice. It is to be given a note, Madeira wine is optional, use with or some amount of Madeira wine in this cake. Fruit sponge, prepare the cake mixture same as butter sponge. Add crystallized fruits and bake. Rock cake, sieve flour and baking powder, rub in butter until it forms breadcrumbs consistency. Add crystallized fruits, add essence into milk and mix into dry ingredients. Put the mixture into the tin and bake. Date and walnut cake. Wash, stone and chop water and keep overnight. Prepare the cake mixture same as butter sponge. Fold flour, dates and nuts alternatively. Put the mixture in a cake tin and bake. Cool overnight and use. Fruit cake. Add rum or brandy in crystallized fruits. Add spices, lemon rind, lemon juice and keep it at least for 30 minutes. Sieve, flour, baking powder, cream, butter and sugar together. Beat eggs. Add essence and mix gradually into butter cream. Fold flour alternatively with fruits for batter into cake tin and bake. Cool for 24 hours and then use. Plum cake. Adopt fruit cake method in this cake. Bake, cool and use. Now we are going to discuss the utility of fatless sponge. To prepare Swiss roll, Charlotte Royal, fruit truffle, pineapple pastries, etc. Genoise sponge is used for different types of gâteaux, petit fours, and the butter sponge can be used for decorated cakes for tea, coffee. The chocolate sponge is used for making cake rusk. Madeira cake is used for making Madeira cake rusk. Fruit sponge is basically used for birthday cakes. Rock cakes, they are being served with tea or coffee. Date and walnut cake, served with tea or coffee. Fruit cake and plum cakes are basically being served during weddings and birthdays and also being served with tea and coffees. Now, I am going to discuss the types of cakes mixing methods. There are two types of cakes. 1. High fat and shortened cakes. 2. Low fat and foam type cakes. The first, high fat or shortened cake. For this, we require sugar batter method. In this, first we make the cream with the help of fat and sugar. Beat eggs stiff for mechanical aeration. Add eggs to the creamed mixture. Sieve all the dry ingredients, that is flour, baking powder, cocoa powder, etc. Add all the dry ingredients to the creamed mixture. Add flavor and color. Add liquid to adjust consistency. Second is blending method. High ratio flow is mixed in a mixer with an emulsified type of fat. Cream fat and flour and other powders as baking powder, soda bicarbonate, salt, etc. Add sugar and part of water or milk at low speed. Beat eggs and remaining water, milk and add to the mixture in three parts. Third, flour batter method. This method is used mainly in high ratio on cakes, that is, cakes that have as higher ratio of sugar and liquid as compared to flour. These cakes have a greater shelf life, good eating quality and are moist, light and tender with fine even grain. Creams fat and flavor of equal quantity until light and fluffy. Sugar and eggs of equal quantity are beaten together until stiff. Add both mixtures together. Sieve, flour, baking powder and any other dry ingredients and flavorings and fold it. Dissolve the remaining sugar in milk or water and add to the mixture. This method is also followed when the flour is of high quality, that is, strong flour, high gluten content. Fat and flour are creamed together so that they get shortened. Now, we are going to discuss about low fat or foam type cakes. Foaming or sponge method. In this, heat butter and liquid. In this method, beat eggs and sugar over a hot water, both until thick and foamy. Remove from heat. Fold in the sifted flour and other dry ingredients. Gently fold in the butter. Take care not to overmix. Pour into a prepared pan and bake immediately. Delays will cause loss in volume. Angel food method. Sift flour and half the sugar. Beat egg whites until they form soft peaks. Add salt and cream of tartar. Beat in sugar until they form soft glossy peaks. Fold in flour sugar mix until thoroughly absorbed but not too much. Pour into prepared pan and bake immediately. Chiffon method. Sift all the dry ingredients including part of the sugar. Beat and add the oil, then the yolks and water, liquid and flavorings all in a slow steady steam. Mix until smooth. Whip egg whites until they form soft peaks. Add cream of tartar and sugar and beat until thick and glossy. Fold whites into the flour, mix liquid, pour immediately into baking pan. All in one process. It is made in a mixer. Flour has to be of a weaker quality and the fat used is of emulsified type, that is, it can carry extra liquid without curdling. All the ingredients are put together in a mixer. It is whisked on a low speed for about a minute to combine the dry ingredients with the liquid. Whisk on high speed for 2 minutes for aeration. Then whisk on low speed for 1 minute for uniform aeration. Apart from these categories, other categories of cake in is dough lean cake and rich cake. This categorization again depends upon the ingredients that are used in making them. Now, I am going to discuss about cake faults. The first problem normally we find in cakes is the shape fault. It collapses cakes with white surface spots. Too much of tenderizers used, which in turn prevents the cake from settling in the center. Too much sugar, thus the white spots. Baked cake with a peaked top. Oven temperature too high. Flour used too strong, thus it resists breaking and only stretches. Cake with flat top. Temperature of oven is too cool, insufficient liquid added to the batter. Now, we discuss about structural faults. Underbaked area or under top crust. Temperature of oven too high, cakes removed from oven in the middle of baking process. Faulty testing of the cake. Fruits fall to the base of the cake. Fruits are not coated with flour. They are not washed and dried properly to remove excess syrup. Batter is too thin. Weak flour used. Excess sugar and tenderizer, which does not allow structure to form. Excess baking powder and fat and the oven at low temperature. The fruit cake crumbles when the low oven temperature, thus excessive moisture loss. Too much fruits used. Fruits are too dry or flour used is too weak. There is streaks in the crumb or cakes. It is due to insufficient mixing of flour during processing. Failure to scrap the bowl during processing. Another problem we find is seams in cakes, that is dense layers. It is because moving a cake in the oven while it is baking causing some layers to collapse and stick to each other. Tunnel-like holes in the cakes, it is because of too much baking powder, fat not mixed properly, over-mixing of batter and batter not put all at once in the baking pan. The third kind of faults we find is of texture faults. In this, the first can be a coarse texture. It is because of the too much of tenderizer that caused the cake to take too long to bake, which in turn results in moisture loss, low oven temperature. The second problem is greasy texture. It is because of excess fat or greasing of tin and pan. Compact texture. It is because of less tenderizers, more liquid over mixing of batter, hot or too cold batter to which emulsion is broken and thus the batter curdles and gets less volume. Now, the another fault is of crust faults. In this, it can be a thick crust. It is because of high oven temperature, low moisture and humidity levels. Another, top crust peels and flakes. And it is because of oven temperature is too low, overbaking, lack of humidity and excess baking powder. Sometimes we find rings of fat around the cake. It is because of excess of fat. Sometimes we find a color faults. It is because of the crumbs discoloration in fruit cakes. Baking time too long, color of fruits is transferred to the crumb. Excessive heat from bottom that causes the base to overbake. Excessive baking powder. Sometimes we get a pale crust color. It is because of less sugar, slow baking, low oven temperature and too much humidity. The another problem we find is of white spots on cake surface. And it is because of too much sugar, less liquid and too much color. Another problem is crumb discoloration in white cakes. And it is because of too much baking powder and sugar, low oven temperature and over baking. Therefore, loss of moisture. Transfer of fruit color, unclean vessel or eggs beaten in an aluminium bowl can be another reason for it. Then we have miscellaneous faults. It is because of mold growth in cakes, too much moisture, wrapping of cakes when still warm, cakes stored with moldy cakes, baking in contaminated wrappers, handling with unclean hands. Now, we are going to discuss about cake characteristics. These include appearance, characteristics of crust, texture, crumb, aroma, and flavor. First, we discuss about the appearance. The appearance of cake involves two main factors before it is tasted. These factors are as follows. The first one is color. A golden brown color is always preferred in cakes, although partially The color is influenced by the ingredients used in cake making. Color must be uniform and without spots. Too dark or light color is not indicated of quality and is not recommended. Second, shape or volume. A uniformly shaped, well-risen cake indicates good quality. Sunken or peaked cakes are considered undesirable. Now, the characteristics of crust. A thin, soft, tender crust is always considered a preferred and desirable parameter for a good cake. A thick, uneven, too tough, too moist or sticky crust indicates poor quality. Now, texture. The fineness or coarseness of the grain of a cake influences the texture. Grain refers to the cell structure of a cake. A soft and velvety texture is always preferred. Cakes having compact, rough, too loose, lumpy, and crumbly textures are considered poor in quality, and these characteristics are not recommended. Now, crumb. The crumb should be soft with the sheen-like appearance. It should be lustrous and free from any patches. It should be tender and moist. A crumbly and dry characteristic refers to the poor quality of the crumb. Uniform color without patches is desirable for cakes. Aroma and flavor. A delicate, sweet, well-blended characteristics of the ingredient provides a pleasant flavor to the cakes. On the other hand, bitter, rancid, flat, strong, and sharp aroma indicates a poor quality of cakes. Sweet and pleasant cakes are always good in quality, and the taste of such cakes is sweet and pleasant. In addition, the aftertaste of the cakes should not leave any unpleasant taste in the mouth. Now, we are going to discuss about balancing of cake formula. The following are some points which should be followed while balancing the cake formula. The first is, salt content will vary between 8 to 2% depending on the quantity of the sugar and amount of flavor desired in the product. Second, as the percentage of the sugar is increased, the percent of the egg should also be increased by approximately at the same percent. Third, when liquid sugars such as honey, corn syrup, etc. are used in the formula, these moisture contents should be known and necessary amendments should be made so that the total moisture content of formula does not change. Fourth, when cocoa is used in the formula, it is necessary to increase the moisture content because cocoa acts as a dryer, where necessary, fat should also be increased. Fifth, when using cocoa, sodium bicarbonate is used. Sixth, slight acidic in egg whites improves its air entrapping capacity, such as lemon. Seventh, when egg yolk is desired to be used, additional moisture is necessary. Eighth, too much milk solid will give undesirable results in cake. Now, I am going to discuss different equipments used in sponge and cake making. They are cake molds, Severin molds, round molds, serrated knife, palette knife, piping bag and nozzles, turntable, flat paddle, balloon or wire whisk, wire rack, silpat. Now, there are certain points to remember while baking. First, preheat the oven. Second, make sure the oven and shelves are leveled. Third, do not let pans touch each other while baking. This prevents air circulation and cake rises unevenly. Fourth, bake at the correct temperature, that is too hot and the cake sets unevenly or before it has fully risen. Crust will be dark. If it is too cool, then the cake will have poor volume and texture. It may not sit properly and could collapse. Fifth, do not open oven doors or disturb cake until they have finished rising. 6. Its steam is available. Use this for creamed or two-stage batter. This steam prevents the top crust from forming and ensures a flat top. 7. Testing for doneness. In this, shortened cakes will shrink away from the sides. Cakes will be springy, center of cake will spring back when pressed. A knife or toothpick inserted in the center will come out clean. Now, I am going to summarize this module. We have learned about different basic sponges prepared in baking. We have also discussed the functions of ingredients and different cake making methods. We have also understood cake faults and characteristics of the cakes. Thanking you and have a nice day.